Now, will you listen? Verse 12. My people ask counsel of their idols, and their staff declareth unto them. For the spirit of harlotry hath caused them to err, and they have played the harlot, departing from under their God. Now he's speaking here of the harlotry, spiritual adultery, which is turning from God. They went to inquire of idols. And today, we find people running after the gurus of India. Well, they haven't done much for India, by the way. But yet, we've had a crowd running after them. And someone has said that one of them that came over here has said that very candidly, he came for the money. And that it was nothing in the world but a religious racket as far as he was concerned. Yet people went after it. People are going off into this type of thing today. And there's actually the worship of Satan today. I have here a clipping that comes from Daytona Beach, Florida. A group of Satan cultists tortured and beat a 17-year-old youth to death, believing he was an undercover narcotics agent, police said Wednesday. May I say to you that worship of Satan today is certainly not helping morality by any means. And these people, going into idolatry, idolatry was leading them into gross immorality. Now, let me keep reading here. And they sacrifice, this is verse 13 now, chapter 4, they sacrifice upon the tops of the mountains and burn incense upon the hills under oaks and poplars and elms because the shadow of them is good. That's where they put their idols, was on top of a hill under a grove. And you hear a great deal in Scripture. And they found out today, archaeologists, that the center of worship of idolatry was in these groves. It was cool there. Nice place to go. Therefore, your daughters shall commit harlotry, and your spouses shall commit adultery. You see, the worship of idols, and we today have turned to idolatry, covetousness. All of this today, the greed of this country today, has caused many a family to try to get on in the world. They want to move to a better neighborhood. They want a swimming pool. They want a boat to take down. And they say, we're doing this for their children. And then all of a sudden, their children take off. And there are thousands of young people today that are wandering up and down this country and all over the world. I saw them in the Hawaiian Islands. I talked to three young people in Constitution Square in Athens, Greece, two young men and a young lady, and I'm sure that none of them were beyond their teens. One of them could have been 20. And there they sat, and they were then under the influence of drugs. I tried to talk with them, and I tried to find out who they were. And they said, we're nobody. We don't count. We've dropped out. What's happened today, friends? What's taking place today? Why, the problem is back there in the home. We're idolatrous. We're worshiping the almighty dollar. We've forgotten God. We've turned away from the living and true God, and we no longer worship him. And we've not turned to a Savior that can redeem us and help us. Now, verse 14. He says, I will not punish your daughters when they commit harlotry, nor your spouses when they commit adultery, for they themselves are separated with harlots, and they sacrifice with harlots. Therefore, the people that doth not understand shall fall. God says ignorance, so the law excuses no one. And because these people have gone off, I'm not going to judge them for the sin they're committing right now. I'm going to judge them because they've turned from the living and true God and from his way. My friend, as I said to a man, and I met him on a golf course, by the way, and he joined our foursome. He soon left us when he found out we were three preachers. And this man made a statement. Well, he said that he guessed that he was a sinner. He'd done this, that, and the other. Said, yes, I guess I'll go to hell. And I said, brother, you know you're not going to hell because you commit these sins. He says, what do you mean? I'm not going to hell because I thought that's what you preachers said. I said, this preacher never said that. I said, you're going to hell because you've rejected Jesus Christ. These people were being judged not because they had become harlots. They were judged because they turned from the living and true God. Now will you notice, he says here, though thou, Israel, play the harlot, yet let not Judah offend, and come not ye unto Gilgal, neither go ye up to Beth Aven, nor swear the Lord liveth. God says, I'm going to hold Judah back. I'll not judge Judah yet. And Judah, don't come up and worship these calves that they put up here.